Math 2, Unit 6, Square Root and Inverse Variation Functions. One should study mathematics simply because it helps to arrange one's ideas. As we begin this unit, use this quote to help you reflect on why it's important to study mathematics. The big ideas for this unit include ideas about square root and inverse variation functions. You'll create multiple representations of these functions, find their key features, interpret their key features in context, perform function transformations, write equations when given a graph or context, solve one-variable equations and inequalities, and solve systems of equations. In lessons 1 and 2, you will be introduced to two new functions, the square root and inverse variation functions. You will use square root functions to model a relationship involving the speed of a tsunami wave and the depth of a disturbance at the bottom of the ocean. You will use an inverse variation function to model the relationship between the speed of the wave and the time that it will take for the wave to reach land. You will create tables and graphs to represent these functions, and then you will identify and interpret key features of the functions. In lessons 3 and 4, you will write and solve inverse variation and square root equations and inequalities. In lesson 3, you will collect data to explore the relationship between time, height, and length of a ramp. You will build on your prior knowledge about direct variation to discover inverse variation relationships. You will learn how to identify inverse variation relationships and write and solve inverse variation equations. In lesson 4, you will write and solve one-variable inverse variation and square root equations and inequalities with graphs and tables. In lesson 5, you will create multiple representations of quadratic, square root, and inverse variation parent functions. You will find their key features and then apply what you have learned about function transformations of quadratic functions to transform square root and inverse variation functions. In lesson 6, you will apply what you have learned about function transformations to write equations of square root and inverse variation functions when you are given a graph of a function. In lessons 7, 8, and 9, you will solve inverse variation and square root equations. In lesson 7, you will develop strategies for algebraically solving these equations. You will critique solving strategies and reasoning of others, and you will discover extraneous solutions. In lesson 8, you will practice writing and solving systems of equations where one equation is linear and the other is either an inverse variation or square root equation. The unit wraps up with lesson 9, where you will refine your understanding of extraneous solutions and practice solving square root and inverse variation equations. Here is a list of key vocabulary terms for this unit. Some of these vocabulary terms should already be familiar to you from previous courses and units. Here are some key skills needed to be successful with the content of this unit. You should be able to solve quadratic equations, solve systems of equations with graphs and tables, and perform function transformations with quadratic functions. In addition to your teacher and school-based resources, there are several additional resources available. The Ready, Set, Go homework help videos are housed in the Canvas site for your class. You can access these in Canvas using your student login. If you do not know how to log into Canvas, then ask your teacher for help. The K-12 Math Resources website, which can be found on your school's website, includes additional support items, such as unit and lesson overviews, videos overviewing the tasks, essential vocabulary, the North Carolina standards for each unit, learning targets for each lesson, and extra practice problems.